In this video, we will show how to assemble the cylinder heads of a VW Type 1 engine, and what you need to pay extra attention to. When you disassemble the cylinder heads, we recommend that you also disassemble the cylinders to fit them with a new gasket between cylinder and crankcase. We refer to video 18 and 19 of this series for more explanation of the cylinders and pistons. The liquid gasket between cylinders and crankcase requires relatively quick processing. You will need to perform the assembly of the cylinders and cylinder heads together, ideally within half an hour of applying the liquid gasket. To be sure, check that the arrow on the pistons faces the flywheel. We have drawn an additional arrow with permanent marker pen, because the mark applied by the factory is not always easily visible. More information on how to assemble the pistons can be found in video 19 of this series. Here we show the engine with cylinders fitted with a fresh liquid gasket between cylinders and crankcase. Check the presence of the cooling air deflection plate at the bottom of the cylinders. This plate must be mounted first before the cylinder heads are attached. It is important that the crankcase nuts are tightened to the correct torque. If the crankcase halves were not split earlier, it is best to check that first. We now measure the diameter of the threaded rods, also called case studs, to be sure about the final torque of the cylinder heads. We measure an outer diameter of about 9.9 millimeters. If we consult a table of bolt dimensions, we see that 9.9 millimeters corresponds to M10. For this engine with M10 nuts, the tightening torque is 32 Newton meters, as we will explain later. The cam followers will receive little lubrication for the first few seconds, during the first start of the engine. By manually providing extra oil, you will avoid unnecessary wear on the cam followers and pushrods. Next, clean the surfaces in which the rubber gaskets of the pushrod tubes will sit. The surfaces should not have any irregularities or damage, which could lead to oil leaks. If you reuse the old cylinder heads, preferably assemble them on the same side. The cylinder heads are identical left and right. You may basically mount a cylinder head left or right, it does not matter. Both cylinder heads have a cooling deflection plate at the bottom, with an opening to mount the cooling air thermostat rod. We are reusing the old cylinder heads. We had marked them with cylinder 1 and 2, and cylinder 3 and 4, to identify the respective right and left cylinder heads. The bottom four washers should be fitted with liquid gasket to prevent oil leaks. Use a liquid gasket that is resistant to engine oil. We use gray Loctite SI5699 for this application. Do not apply lavishly, just enough to seal the area between washer and cylinder head. For this AB1300, the tubes should be between 190 mm and 191 mm long. We have devoted an additional video to fitting the pushrod tubes, which is video 20 of this video series. You can adjust the tubes in length, but don't make them longer than necessary. That will make cylinder head assembly more difficult. Next, slide the rubber gaskets onto the pushrod tubes, with their tapered side facing outward. Use glycerin to help the rubber slide better during assembly. Our engine hangs from the engine mount, but you can also assemble the cylinder heads with the engine on the workbench. Slide the cylinder head over the 8 case studs. A gasket is not necessary between cylinder head and cylinder. Metal rings are sometimes used. We refer to video 5 of our engine diagnostic series for this. With the engine mount, we can tilt the engine, which makes fitting the pushrod tubes a little easier. When tilting, be careful that the cylinders, or cylinder heads, cannot come loose and fall to the ground. Place the first tube between the crankcase and cylinder head. The seam of the tube should preferably be pointed upwards, to avoid possible oil leaks should the tube be damaged. Then slide the pushrod into the tube. The pushrod is a useful tool to hold the tube in place. Do the same with the three other tubes. Make sure the seam of the pushrod tubes is facing up. You can see that the pushrods are holding the tubes in place as you assemble them one at a time. By rotating the tubes a bit, you will quickly feel if the gaskets are properly in place. Not all types of tubes have a seam, but if they do, assemble them with the seam facing up. Place the top four washers over the case studs. We have already put the four bottom washers in place with liquid gasket. Use a light to medium strength locking compound on the threaded rods to give the nuts an extra lock. For example, Loctite 243. Screw the 8 nuts onto the case studs. First, tighten them by hand until resistance can be felt. The order has little importance at this point. You can use a socket wrench to tighten the 8 nuts manually. The pushrod tubes are ideal, always slightly longer than necessary, because they have to be mounted with pressure. They will exert back pressure at the bottom of the cylinder head. Tighten the bottom four nuts until the cylinder head is approximately parallel to the cylinders. This is a good starting point to torque the cylinder head nuts. Now you may tighten the nuts in the order and according to the tightening torques prescribed in the VW workshop manual. We show here the tightening torques of the cylinder head nuts in Newton meter for all Type 1 engines. The values are different depending on the year of manufacture and on the size of the cylinder head nuts. For all Type 1 engines, you can use an initial tightening torque of 10 Newton meter. Tighten large parts always starting from the middle to prevent warping. So you start with the lower nuts from the middle outwards. Then the top four nuts, from the middle, outwards. The final tightening is done with a torque between 25 and 32 Newton meters, depending on the size of the threaded rods and cylinder head nuts. Consult the values for your engine type before starting this job. For the final tightening sequence, tighten the four middle nuts first in a cross pattern, then the four outer ones also in a cross pattern. Tighten first with 10 Newton meters, starting with the middle nuts at the bottom. Then tighten the outer nuts at the bottom with 10 Newton meter. Now tighten the middle nuts at the top, and then the outer nuts at the top, still with 10 Newton meter. Then you may tighten the nuts with the final torque and final tightening order. For this AB1300 with M10 nuts, that's 32 Newton meters. This does not seem like much, but remember that due to heat, the cylinder heads and cylinders will expand, exerting more force on the nuts. While tightening, check that the rubber gaskets are still properly seated in the crankcase and cylinder head. Also check that the seam of the tubes are facing up. The entire operation, fitting the cylinders with liquid gasket and tightening the cylinder heads, should be completed within the hour to avoid the liquid gasket drying up. Next, you may assemble the rocker arm. We refer to video 14 of this series. For safety, seal all holes to avoid that small parts would end up in the engine. In the next video of this series, this is video 18, we will discuss the disassembly of the cylinders and pistons. Also watch video 20 to learn more about the pushrod tubes. We also explain in this video how to install new tubes without loosening the cylinder heads. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon.